Good morning to all. This is Samyak here from Kidvento Education, and today I will be briefing you about 3D printing. And also, the topic for today is from design to reality, where we will understand different concepts of how to design, how to do prototyping, and how to also make products out of it. Let's wait for everyone to participate for another 2 or 3 minutes, and we will begin. For ample amount of time in the meeting, everyone will be muted till the briefing is over, and then there will be a session for everyone to ask their doubts and questions. Also, till that time, I will be talking with you. First of all, good morning, ellarigu namaskara. ನಾನು ಇವಾಗ 3D ಪ್ರಿಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ಕೊಡಕ್ಕೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ. ಸೊ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಟು ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ದ ಕೋರ್ ವೇರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ರೈಟ್ ನೌ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗ್ತಿರೋದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ 3D ಪ್ರಿಂಟಿಂಗ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾಹಿತಿ ಕೊಡಕ್ಕೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ 3D ಪ್ರಿಂಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಎನಿ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಮಾಡೆಲ್. And this has a bit of a process of how to design, how to model, and etc. So be patient and listen to the whole briefing so that you can understand a lot about this concept and also about this technology. So first, in a journey of building a product or a model, first is to how to convert idea and then from idea to design. So in the beginning, I will tell you about what is CAD. So CAD is basically a tool. It's like a tool from which we can convert any idea of our brain into a simple design. It can be architectural design, it can be mechanical, it can be civil of any kind. Also, there are very basic CAD design softwares where children also can do these designs. Makkalu design softwares na use madak agabodu ast easy aagi now adana explain martivi. It's a very important tool in which simple and complex objects can be designed from a very basic bucket of a dice or cards, anything you can see, bottles and all that. This all is done in CAD softwares. And there are many applications, as said, and majority of them are to make the buildings, mechanical designs, etc. So the next question comes into picture is, why do we need designs? So for anyone to make any creation, for any invention to occur, we need basic design. For example, let's take a very simple example of bucket. When we go to buy a bucket, if all the buckets are not in a similar size, the person will get confused. Also, if they are not consistent, if they are not proper, then there is a major issue of people backlashing. That's why it's very important to have a specific design. You can take examples of for example, buckets, pen caps, pens, etc. So that's how designs make impact on real life products. Next comes how are CAD used in mechanical designs. So here I will show a very small video of how normal designs are made from 2D models to a bit complicated designs like tires, like tail lamps, head lamps, etc. And in the end, the picture will be very different. Like there are a lot of tools used to make a small, simple sketch design to a really beautiful model of car. Yes. You can see that each and every plane, each plane has been selected, each plane has been edited and made into a very small sections of design. And then in the end, what you get is the real, total design. For example, as you can see here, like each, the tires are been made, the rims are been made, the whole car model is been made totally using these kind of softwares. So this is a bit complicated section of this, because here you have a lot of things to learn, but it all starts with the very basic and simple designs. I will show one more video where these kind of designs or CAD softwares are used in civil and architecture. So here you can see that this whole CAD design has been made for making buildings. You can make cars movable, cars, buildings, and everything. And it is opening, and you can see that everything has been generated in computer designs. Everything, whatever is visible, is developed in computer software. And this will be implemented in real life also. So this is where the bigger picture comes in, where you can see that CAD designs are being used in this kind of very complex and complicated structures. Also, these all are the parts where you can see simple objects have been placed. So now you people have a bit of an understanding that what really is a CAD model. CAD model is a 3D model of any object, whatever it can be. For example, this is a Colosseum model here, which is placed, and where you can see. Now, the second step is from design to prototype. And this is where 3D printing comes into picture. 3D printing is the only tool right now possible which can convert any design into prototypes, and which are very specifically built to do complex shapes, complicated structures, and all that. So 3D printing is very simple. For example, you can see a CAD model in your on your right hand side, sorry, left hand side, and the prototype of 3D printed part on the right hand side. You can see there is not much visible change between these two models, as it is exactly the replication of the CAD model into a real object. This is made using 3D printers, and possibly also made using these tools known as 3D printing or prototyping. So what happens is that in a 3D printing software, the CAD model is being changed into small slices of the same CAD model. For example, here you can see the CAD model in object A. Then it has been sliced into straight lines in Z axis into, for example, around hundreds of slices. Then the edging of the model takes place. And when the printing is occurring, the physical stacking and pasting of layer takes place, which I'll be explaining you later. And the finished prototype is complete. So this is the whole process of how 3D printing occurs. Right now, whatever 3D printers you are getting, we will be using biodegradable plastic known as PLA. And that's really efficient in making a lot of prototypes. So first, I'll just show you a basic idea how it works. So you have seen a 3D pen or a glue gun. So basically, a glue gun, we put small layers, and we can make a real 3D model here. For example, here you can see that small layers of objects been put to make a real object like this guitar set. So the layers are very small, and we can do it by hand using a 3D pen or a glue gun. Just imagine the same process being done using a 3D printer or a machine. And that's where the whole journey from imagination to reality starts. You can see that each and every pore has been filled using plastics. These are thermosetting plastics. Basically, whatever you see in your buckets, chairs, and all that, those are all thermosetting plastics. And this is the same kind in such a way that we create our own objects. Here you can see the guitar has been created using small reels of objects, which I'll be showing later. Now you can see what real 3D printing looks like. So here the whole concept of 3D printing is taking a model and making it layer by layer going upwards. So it has been sliced up, and now it has been placed like small object. You can see the timer there. It is taking around 20 to 25 hours to complete a print. That may seem a lot of time, but in reality it is less, because normally to do machining to do cutting and all that, it is going to take lot more time than this. Also, here you can, there is a very visible example where two mating parts, for example, a screw and a screw handle has been printed. And this printing takes place very slowly. As you can observe, it takes a lot of hours to print it. Then it has been removed from the bed plate. And you can see these two parts been exactly fit like a container. So we can produce these kind of parts too. Just a second. Also, you can see the time lapses of the 3D printing. It is layer by layer printing. It's just like putting lots of papers one upon another. And then imagining that this is going to take place and make an object. These objects are used in mechanical industries, civil industries, and a lot of other industries ever possible. So there may be doubts of someone like, can 3D printing be really used in showing up objects or making up parts which are movable or mechanically viable? So you can see here that these are Spirogyra, or you can say that these are all algae inside the ocean, which are exact representation of whatever model we will be able to design. And last but not the least, this is the part where four or five parts have been printed one over other, and these are movable. Like right now, you can see this has been printed as a robot. And now in the next phase, we can bend these parts to make a real robot out of it. Like you can see here now that these all parts are going to bend, and we can be able to make one kind of robot, which has all the movable parts like hinges, like hand motions. And this is a single print. It doesn't have any separate parts. It doesn't have any parts which are separated from each other, etc. And still we can print it together. So there are basically four types of prototyping, or else as you call 3D printing. There is one known as 3D inkjet printing. There is laser engineered net shaping, selective laser melting, and electron beam melting. We will be having more focus on inkjet printing, or also known as FDM, fused deposition manufacturing. So basically what happens here is there is one small roll of 3D printer filament, which is getting heated up to 200 degrees Celsius, which is the melting point of PLA. And after that, there is a semi-solid, as you can see on the slide, there is a semi-solid flow of this filament over the plate to make objects. It is sliced printing. That means that each object is being sliced into a lot of slices like papers. These papers are stacked upon one another to make a real object out of it, as you have seen in the time-lapse videos before. So right now I can show you on my hand, there is one object which we have 3D printed. You can see the intricate shapes. You can see how the models are getting real close. Also, I have an object, for example, everyone can recognize this. This is Eiffel Tower. And this is also 3D printed. You can see that these kind of objects we can 3D print out of this filament. So here you can see the material spool, which is going to take up into a heater, and then the heater is going to print a 3D printed part. There is a similar video I can show where we can really define all these parts together. There is one more type known as stereolithography, or else SLA, where liquid resin is used and a laser beam is used to make a small and really intricate shapes and parts. So right now I'm going to show you a video of our own 3D printers, which we manufacture. Here you can see the reel. There is a small PLA filament going inside the heater box. This is the heater box, the blue section you are watching. And there is a small layers of the 3D printed part forming on. Right now we are printing ABS. Therefore, the temperature is, So we have... So here you can see on the screen that there is the temperature is 240 degrees Celsius and the bed temperature is 90 degrees Celsius. And this is the X, Y, Z axis and how much percentage of print has been done. Okay, so in chat, I have received the response that I should explain Kannada also. Yes, I will. Just a second. So, illi new note bodo illi 3D print aagthirudu. So, basically, yenagutte antandre one chick nozzle a filament na bisi maadibittu al kelagade print madutte slow aagi print madutte atatra one part print aake 3 inda 4 taas tagobodu illa onnond sathi 3 inda 4 dina tagolutte illi neevu nortirudu blue color box adu heater adu plastic na 225 illa 240 degrees tanka heat madutte heat maadadmele allinda barudu semi solid illa semi liquid yen irutte ಅದು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ನೋಡಬಹುದು ಆ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಸ್ಪೂಲ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತನಕ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಪೂಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ 1 kg ಸ್ಪೂಲ್ ಇದು 1 kg ಸ್ಪೂಲ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಹೊರಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕಾಣ್ತಿರೋದು ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿಗ್ರೀಸ್ ಹೀಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂತ 240 ಡಿಗ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿ 80 ಡಿಗ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿ ಆತರ advantages of 3D printing like there are lots of advantages of 3D printing. One is that it does not require any precursor or it does not require anything which for example like molds or something like that before. So illi neevu nodabodu this is like this is called as a glue gun or else you normally you use in electronics or you use in some mechanical parts to be printed. So glue gun na now design maadibittu CAD modeling alli now ee tara models na chik chik dagi maadibittu now 3D print maadabodu nan on chik basic model heng maadodu anta on 5 minutes alli tors bidtene so illi nan use maartiru software Tinkercad which is freely available ella kade now free aagi idana use maadabodu illi now design create anta kortivi or else we give it like create a design here you can see that there is one work plane there are some models here are they visible yes there are some models here so we select on one of the model we drag and drop it here so this is a basic cube now if you go on this you can see this that we can change the dimensions now dimensions change maadabodu for example length namge 50 bekide so 50 maadabodu ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ 30 ಬೇಕಿದ್ರೆ 30 ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಇವಾಗ ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ನ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಅದರ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಒಂದು ರೂಫ್ ತರ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ರೂಫ್ ಅಂತ ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಡ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದನ್ನ ರೊಟೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ 90 ಡಿಗ್ರೀಸ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಬೇಕು ಸೊ 90 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ರೊಟೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಹೀಗೆ ಎತ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇದನ್ನ ಮತ್ತೆ ಗ್ಲೈಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಸೈಜ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಶೇಪ್ ನ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇದು ಇನ್ನ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಇವಾಗ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ ರೂಫ್ ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಇವಾಗ ನಾನೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಸೈಜ್ ನಾವು ಮುಂಚೆ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ರೆಕ್ಟಾಂಗಲ್ ಸೈಜ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ ಅದೇ ಸೇಮ್ ಸೈಜ್ ನ ನಾವು ಕೊಡ್ತೀವಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನಾವು ಬ್ರೆಡ್ 30 ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ ನಾವು ಲೆಂತ್ 50 ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ವಿ ಸೊ ಅಷ್ಟು ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನಾವು ರೀಶೇಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಬಹುದು ನೀವು ಒಂದ್ ಮನೆ ತರ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಇವಾಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಬಾಗ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಅ ಡೋರ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಅ ವಿಂಡೋ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಸಿಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಅ ಡೋರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಆನ್ ಅನದರ್ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಅ ಬಿಟ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ನೌ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅರೌಂಡ್ 5 mm ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟು ಬಿ 5 mm ಅಂಡ್ I can decrease the height also to 5 mm and this is a very small box now I will so there is a option here known as hole if I click on the option hole I can create a small hole inside the building for example like this so there is a small hole now if I click on export and if I click on export and on STL you can see here that this model is getting exported here, as you can see here in the bottom. Now, if I go on Qura and open it up, you can see this house has been created with a roof and with a door, with a very small door. But this is how very simple, simple objects can be created in the beginning. And then later on, we can create bigger objects or complex objects also. Okay, now back from design, let's go back to the presentation. So 3D printing, what are the advantages of 3D printing? As I said, it does not require any mold or precursor to manufacture. it does not require, for example, if you want some part to be printed, you can see here, this is a mold for a remote control. And from that mold, the real remote control has been taken out or manufactured. 3D printing does not require that. It can print multiple parts in one cycle, like you can see here on the plate. We can print small objects, for example, of this very small size to larger or bigger objects to this size. So these require different 3D printing techniques, but we can 3D print a lot of such objects of different sizes. The geometrical complexity is not a limitation. We can print these kind of very geometrically complex shapes. For example, you can see this star shape, which we cannot manufacture using any other technique. Only using 3D printing, we can manufacture these kind of products. Applications like we can have our own texture, our own feel. Here you can see that there are some monuments being 3D printed, which gives exactly the same representation of the real monument. For example, I can show you one. So this is the Colosseum in my hand, which we have 3D printed using same exact color and material. The material may be PLA, but the color is exactly the same, so that you people will get better understanding of how a real Colosseum may look like. You can see small intricate shapes also inside them. The doors, there are tops are having some bifurcations and all that. Yes. Now I will show a time-lapse video of a very futuristic model of 3D printing. Whatever you are watching is a 3D printed house being 3D printed, a real time house. And it takes only 24 hours. It takes only 24 hours to 3D print a house. And you can see here that each and every layer is being 3D printed. The whole house has been constructed at a real time size. And it takes only 24 hours to complete the whole house. So 3D printing has a lot of potential in future, and also a lot of applications, like in construction, for example, constructing very complex shapes in a very small amount of time or size, or maybe there may be monuments. There may be a lot of such things which can be 3D printed. For example, right now there are people building windmills using 3D printers. This is the windmill's tower being 3D printed exactly. Next. So these are small buildings which we have 3D printed on our own 3D printers using FDM technology or whatever, or you can call it using PLA material. You can see a small details inside them. For example, the towers, the buildings, there are windows over them, there are balconies, and all these kind of stuff being printed exactly as the dimensions and details are. So basically, you can have your own miniature house being 3D printed on the model. There are a lot more applications of 3D printing. For example, these tires are being 3D printed, the seats are being 3D printed. So before any manufacturing occurs, before any industrial manufacturing occurs, these products are 3D printed and checked and tested if exactly these things work. They are exactly to the size which they want. For example, you want a bucket to hold around 20 liters of water. You have designed the bucket, then you 3D print it using this FDM technologies or SLA technologies, and you make sure that this exactly fits in, and then you go to mass manufacturing. So 3D printing is the tool which takes your idea, design to reality, and it's the most important part of it. Because if there is a mistake in your 3D printed part, it means your design is faulty, it means your designer has some problems, you will solve them. And this is very cheap, relatively, because for manufacturing, for example, you have designed a bucket and you made a mold out of it. It takes around 3 to 4 lakhs to make the mold. And then later on, it like if it fails, that means around 3 to 4 lakh rupees of investment is gone wrong. In 3D printing, you can make a small bucket for around 20,000 or 25,000, whatever possible. And that saves a lot of cost, lot of time, and lot of your efforts too. Here, this is known as wind tunnel testing, where helmets are being tested. If whatever for whatever reason it breaks into something, is the design perfect for it? Is the design really correct that this won't break if you fall at, for example, around 100 kilometers per hour? If you fall and you are wearing this helmet, will that break you or will that affect your body? So these all parts are 3D printed before they go into mass manufacturing. Validation of inventions. For example, small children have some invention to make. there is a lot of curiosity. For example, gear shafts, springs, anything of that sort. You can 3D print a small model of it, really validate if your idea works. If your idea works, you can just go to mass manufacturing. You can take these kind of models to a lot of people, and you can validate these kind of ideas too. One more thing where these kind of 3D printings are used is before you go to mass manufacturing, you need a precursor. For example, if I want to mass manufacturing this object, is it visible? Yes. So this kind of diamond or the stone, whichever part you want to 3D make it into mass manufacturing for jewelry and all that, we can 3D print these kind of objects first. We can take it to the mold. For example, you want to have a gold ring. Gold ring is very costly, and you want it to be having this exact same design. So you make a 3D printed part out of it. You take it to the jeweler. He will make mold out of it. For example, cast or mold by using sand casting methods and all that. And then these models will get will come into shape in gold. Next, in applications, for example, you want there are casts being made using 3D printing, where these kind of materials. Just a second. Yes, eventually we can 3D print. We can 3D print, and I will take the Q&A session in the later. So you can post your questions here. Yes, and I will answer them later. Not an issue at all. We can 3D print metals. I'll talk about it later. So we can prepare molds for casting. For example, here you can see this cast been prepared, in which, for example, we pour metal, we pour anything of whatever metal we want, whatever plastic we want, and we can make shapes out of them. Here you can see that patterns or jewelry are being 3D printed and then made into real jewelry. For example, I am holding one of them in my hand too, so that you can see exactly how intricately and how beautifully it can be 3D printed. These kind of jewelries also can be 3D printed and to very minimum size. The accuracy of them is around 50 microns. So you can imagine how intricate these shapes are. These can be 3D printed and being converted into metals or any of that sort. So here you can see a lot of different shapes been 3D printed and been made here. There are very small designs, there are rings and all that. Now, for around 5 to 6 minutes, I will show you how these kind of where you can get these kind of designs. You may have some questions where we can get these kind of designs, where can we 3D print this kind of stuff. We can get them for free in a lot of websites. Right now, I will show one of them. So there is something known as Thingiverse, www.thingiverse.com, where you can get a lot of designs which you can take out of box and 3D print them. If you have a 3D printer, you can take any kind of design. For example, let's take a very small example. maybe I want a pen stand. So I can search pen stand into this Thingiverse, and you can see here there are a lot of designs for pen stand. This is a simple four-way pen stand. this is the hexagonal pen stand, this is a bigger one. So these all things can be 3D printed. For example, let's choose one of them. Yes, I will choose this one, the green one, because it is having more of utility. So we go to this space and you can see how it looks, how it holds everything, how the basic design of it looks, how it has been designed, and we can place business cards and what all stuff we can utilize into it. And you can go to download all files. So it will take around 5 seconds here to download any kind of file. And then, yes, it started downloading here. So you can get the zip file here. Then, just a second. So you take all these files and you unzip them. So here we got the files, images, and attributes. So in files, you have something known as a STL file. Is it visible? So this is an STL file here. So if I open this in Cura, which is by the way free also. So now, right now you can see the whole pen stand, which we were looking at. This now can be 3D printed. If I slice it now, where there is a slice option here, we can see how many hours it's going to take to get these things 3D printed. Just a second, it may take a moment or two. Yes, it is going to take 1 day and 11 hours to 3D print this small pen stand. Now, you people may think that normal pen stand will get for 100 rupees or 110 rupees. Why we have to go through this whole 3D printing process? Yes, we don't have to for these simple objects. But what if you want something, for example, ear diagram, or else what we can call as eardrum or lungs? You want a model of lungs to be shown to the students. Here you can see the lungs been 3D printed, exactly the shape and size of these lungs and how it has been 3D printed and all that. Like, if you want these kind of shapes urgently, or you want to show exactly how these shapes look like, you have to have a 3D model, you have to 3D print it and show them to the students. And this is how it's going to work. It is very beautiful. Like, you can 3D print everything. This is that coronavirus. This is DNA. This is the cell. You can 3D print the each and every part of the cell, join it and show it to the, it's very useful in these kind of ways. And this is where, like, Thingiverse, you can get lot of models for free to 3D print. You cannot sell them, but you can 3D print and show them to the students. You can make them understand each and every concept very easy. That I will also explain to you in the later brief. Okay. Yes. So, so we went till jewelry design and all that. Now, the next ones. After jewelry design, we have it into direct tooling. What exactly is direct tooling? It means, for example, you want a tool to be 3D, tool to be made. For example, a hammer. So it needs to have a precursor hammer. It's like, for example, students have exam. So it has a prelims exam. The same way hammer has a precursor plastic model on which things have been tested, the size, the shape, how to make mold out of it. And all this is going to take place and then being converted to real steel hammers. And this is where direct tooling, 3D printing helps in lot of manufacturing industries. For example, your specs. Whatever specs you are wearing are first been prototyped using 3D printed specs. Another thing where 3D printing has been used is in reverse engineering. So in reverse engineering, what reverse engineering means is, for example, I have this vase. I want the same exact vase with us. Just a second. Yeah, so think of this vase. So in the vase, for example, you want the same exact vase to be replicated. You want to make the same exact vase. So what exactly you can do is you can 3D scan it. Like generally imagine a normal printer. So normal printer, you have seen it has a scanner, it has a Xerox machine, and it has a printer. So in normal printer, what happens is whatever paper you put in, yade paper akidre, adu scan aagabodu, adu Xerox maadabodu, adana naavu print ku kodabodu. Same way alli naavu 3D printing alluve same model na naavu 3D scan maadabodu. For example, ee tara vast model irabodu, illa nimge yavadra bekadanta model irabodu. Then we can take that model and replicate it. Andre adana naavu Xerox maadkobodu. In simple words, adu Xerox antivi. ಸೊ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ತಿರ್ಬೋದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಬ್ರೌನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ಇದು ಹಳೆ ಕಾಲದ್ದು ಹಳೆ ಮಾಡಲು ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇದನ್ನ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಈ ತರ ಕಂಪ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜನರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕ್ಯಾಟ್ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇದನ್ನ ಮತ್ತೆ 3D ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರೆಪ್ಲಿಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲಿ ದೀಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಸ್ಟಾರಿಕಲ್ ಇವೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಮಾನ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ ಇದೆ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಯಂ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಡಬೇಕು ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ 3D ಪ್ರಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ Yes, 3D printing is also been used in medical right now, for example, biocompatible material. So now basically one of our client, one client ke now en madidu andre stents, there is something known as stents for children, for any nasal activity. For example, nam mugu dina operation aadmele stent anta haaktare olagade. So chik makkalige doddavardu stents barala, the stents which we have chikkavarge adu apply agala. So those kind of stents we did 3D print also the skull model. For example, in CT scan file ide, CT scan gotirbodu ellarigu, CT scans madustare medicals alli. So in CT scan files, what happens is we get the sliced model of the skull of a small eardrum or anything of that sort. So we take that, we 3D print the exact skull or exact body, whatever part. For example, a fracture agide, micro fractures agide. So the doctor wants to see exactly where the fracture is so that he can operate easily. Operation madakke tumba help agutte avaga. So ee tara now skulls nuve 3D print madabodu, exactly fractured skull agabodu, CT scan skull agabodu, aa tara. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಈ ಸ್ಕಲ್ ಗೆ ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡ್ಯಾಮೇಜ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ 3D ಪ್ರಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಬಯೋಕಂಪಟಬಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ನ ಪ್ರಿಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಾವು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಚಿಕ್ಕದಾಗಿ ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು ಇದು 3D ಪ್ರಿಂಟೆಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಬಯೋಕಂಪಟಬಲ್ ಬಯೋಕಂಪಟಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಹಾಕಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ತೊಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ದೇರ್ ವೋಂಟ್ ಬಿ ಎನಿ ಪೇನ್ ದೇರ್ ವೋಂಟ್ ಬಿ ಎನಿ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ The next one is like 3D printing tissues. Tissues are being 3D printed here. For example, the ear is been 3D printed really exactly of the same size and quality. So when you see this ear, you can imagine that there may be 3D printing of lungs or really vital parts. Yes, heart sata print madidare. A working heart is been printed and been placed in a rat. People are 3D because 3D printing is so flexible in the sense yes correct agi now yaa shape beku yaa size al beku ellanu nodkondo 3D print maadabodu so 3D printing is done in medical industry vastly tumba jana 3D printing medical al maartidare next so illi nodabodu neevu ella types bones agli leg bones aamele skull parts teeth jaws aamele backbone everything in medical industry has been 3D printed till now. These are mass customization andre kivi do machine irutalva so ear machines have to be of different sizes they because everyone's ear is different and especially it has to fit in very properly so adakke en martare we can have exact dimensions been taken from our ear and been 3D printed in the whole process. Yes, now we'll come to materials which are used in 3D printing. Now the metallic materials like plain carbon steel, tool steel, stainless steel, these cannot be 3D printed in FDM technology. These can be 3D printed in something called as SLS, that is sinister laser. And also these can be 3D printed in a lot of different methods which are costlier or really, really costlier and are of not much use in real life. For example, you can see titanium, copper, aluminium. There are engines being 3D printed using titanium metal, using copper metal in this 3D printing technology. The next one is polymers and polymeric compositions. For example, ABS, nylon, PP. So basically, ABS is somewhere. For example, you use the cooker, pressure cooker handle. Pressure cooker handle is made of ABS. Nylons, you have seen a lot of nylons. Polycarbonate also, there are a lot of examples of PCs. PPs, for example, we have plastic bottles, which is PETs, like PETG, or of that sort, PPs. But the basic and the most useful material till now is PLA. There are a lot of 3D printers which print sand, ceramics, elastomers, tungsten, and all that. But whatever printers we will be providing or we will be having with us, or which are really affordable and available in the real market, can 3D print all kind of plastics like PLA, ABS, PETG, etc. and TPU and TPE also. There are a lot of biocompatible materials which I talked about. Biocompatible means you can put this into your any operation or something and still people won't get affected due to this. For example, you can see here PCL, PPTCP. These kind of materials are really complex and these are used in only medical or biomedical application because they are very, very costly. What exactly are the disadvantages of 3D printing is, first of all, the cost. The cost is really higher. It is higher than mass manufacturing. So it can be only used for two or three products or five products or batch manufacturing. Accuracy is not that high. Means you'll get an accuracy of 0.4 mm or 0.1 mm or of that sort. Finish also has some layers. For example, maybe it's visible or not, but there will be some layers. If I scratch it like this, you can see the sound of layers. The strength of the materials really depends upon how the 3D printing has occurred. There are a lot of materials which are very strong and material options are really less. For example, as you saw that materials were only some amount of metals, some amount of 3D printed parts like plastics and all that. Yes. So, before continuing, I want to answer all the questions of the questions and doubts you people have been posing. So, please tell me your doubts. So, there are some doubts here. For example, yes, please explain FDM and SLS technology. Yes. So FDM is where, as you have seen in the video, which I have shown you just a second. So this is what FDM is. Basically, the reel of filament is been taken up and small 1.75 mm diameter filament is taken up by the heater. Then the heater will heat the plastic and 3D print it. In SLS technology or whatever I call SLA or SLS, what happens is in sinister laser technology, there is a small laser, there is a brush there. Unfortunately, I have not kept it here because there are more slides. So in SLA technology, here it is. So SLA and SLS are almost same. Not exactly same, but almost same. So there is a laser beam. So here there is resin here. In SLS technology, there will be powder. And in powder, there will be there will be metal powder mixed with sand. In SLS technology, the small laser beam will fall on the powder and it is basically micro welding. Like it will weld those small powder particles of metal and weld it together to make a small shape. That is what happens in SLS technology. Yes, how much current it consumes per hour or per day? Okay, so basically FDM 3D printers, what we are providing, these ones are 360 watt 3D printers. So in 360 watts, basically it means that it takes in watt per hour ratio, it takes 360 while heating, but normally it takes only 100 watts. So imagine if we run like for 18 hours a day for a month, it will cost around 3,000 to 4,000 rupees. If you run 18 hours a day for a whole month, so it is not that costly. Yes. Anyone else has any doubts, sir? Okay, so I had got a question, sir. Please explain how laser tech. Wait a minute. It'll come from top, I guess. Yes, for normal buildings, which materials are used for making parts of buildings? Okay, for normal buildings, the parts used are is a mixture of cement and tar, and it is like different companies have different patents on it. So we exactly don't know what is the composition exactly, but it is basically a mixture of cement, tar, and two or three additives to make it cure very fast. This technology is still under research, and we don't have it in real life, but we have it. Yes. So can we 3D print metals? Yes, we can. Not in FDM, but in SLS. SLS 3D printer starts from around 5 crores. I guess 5 to 6 crores is the basic cost of an SLS 3D printer. It's a three-part 3D printer, so it's very costly for like schools or colleges, but it is really possible. For building construction, which materials are used? I have talked about this. Yes, explained how laser technology can be used in 3D printing and what is the principle of working behind it. Okay, so once again, I'll tell you like what happens is that laser itself heats the material. Heats the material. For example, you have something known as photography. You have seen the reel photography in the past, where there were reels of material. They were using photoplastics, what we call. Like they are reactive to one exact kind of light. For example, in laser printing, it is like 405 nanometer of wavelength. So at 405 nanometer of wavelength, this resin gets solidified. It is liquid in part, but it gets solidified. And due to which, what happens is each layer will get solidified at one point of time, and slowly the whole solidification process completes, and you get a modeling. Okay. Yes. Cost of which machine are you asking, sir? Because there are a lot of machines here. What is the life of the machine we are providing? Is there any limitation how much we can use them? Yes. So life of the machine. So basically this. So it is not like a normal printer. In normal printer, it is like you put paper and the print comes out. It is a part of a manufacturing sector. So you may understand this will, for example, if you print around 7 days continuously. Okay, in that there will be one day where the printer will have some issues. You have to solve those issues, and then the printer is back and running again. So these kind of machines, all kind of manufacturing machines have something known as a breakdown time. For example, in 15 days, in 15 days, for example, two or three times it may break down if you run continuously. My 3D printer is not working. Can I help you? Yes, sure, sir. I will. One second, I'll answer the question first. This is how you can start from the basic 3D, like 3D printing, and some kind of mass manufacturing 3D printers are there for around 15 to 16 lakh rupees. There are some 3D printers which we provide are of around 2 or 3 lakh rupees. The starting basic minimum is around 2 lakhs or 3 lakhs, and it goes upwards. There are some basic machines which are available in the market, but they are not really efficient machines. We provide the machines which are really efficient and really has a lot of efficiency in it. The accuracy, so cost of basic machine to highest accuracy. So the cost ranges from around 75 to 80,000, and the highest you can go is crores. Like there is no limitation for it. The cost and the accuracy, it is not like balance. Like the more cost, the more you can get it accurate. No. So basically, normal 3D printer is of 25 centimeter size. Okay. You can have sizes varying from 25 centimeter maximum to 100 to 300. Like sizes also vary. Then there are some 3D printers which can go till temperature 400 degrees Celsius. Some which can go till 250 degrees Celsius. So there are lot of variations between the cost and the quality ratio. Okay, any other questions? I still have around 4 to 5 minutes left. Any questions? Did I answer all of them? No, there is no limitation how much you can use, but it should have a cooling time and it should have a heating time. Yes, you have raised hand, but you have not asked the question. Is any there any health implication for continuous? No. So when you use ABS or PETG material, yes, there is a health implication, but when you use PLA material, there is no health implication. Because there was a lot of things on newspapers that there is a health implication of 3D printer, and we provide enclosed 3D printers with fans. So basically, the whole idea is that whenever it is heating, whenever it is heating, it does what do you say? It can cover up all the fumes inside. And if you are printing PLA, there are no fumes at all. What is slicing? Yes, I will show you what is slicing here. So we took a model and we then sliced it. So when we slice it, so just a minute, maybe you can see now. Yes. So what slicing does it? It converts the model into small, 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 small layers, which are visible on the screen right now. So these small layers will define how it is going to 3D print. For example, I'll play a small video of it. So you can see the nozzle 3D printing the whole 3D printing the whole part. Can we make our own 3D printer at ETL with the help of so when I made my first 3D printer, it took me around 4 months to 5 months to build it. And YouTube videos may be helpful for a bit of a part, but not that much. We can get the software for free. You can see on my screen there is Ultimaker Cura, which we can, yes, printed materials we can resell. Sir, it is reusable, recyclable. PLA material is recyclable. Okay. Yeah. So now, so you can see here slicing been taken place. Right now, I have a bit more slides and a bit more information to give. So let me finish it off. Yes. So what exactly 3D printing in education means, and why we have to have 3D printers, printing education here. So this is. Okay. So in 3D printing education, it's a like creative tool. We can express, we can do a lot of designs. And we can do historic models, scientific models, and papers, small inventions. And I'll show around 5 minutes like what exactly we can do in 3D printing. Okay. For example, as I showed you the Colosseum we made. So we did the 3D design, then we 3D printed it. And right now you can see that there is 3D. Just a second. No, okay, I'll answer all the queries. Just give me a 2 minutes. So yes, so this is, for example, we have used to make monuments and colosseums and all these kind of things. Now this can be done. For example, Taj Mahals we can build lot of small, small monuments out of it. As I showed you the eardrum model. So the eardrum can be exactly 3D printed to size, and all the bones are shown here. For example, as you can see. Yes, third one is the in physics. For example, I will show you. So this is Archimedes screw in use to lift the water pump, and this is all 3D printed. You can see that the water is coming out here. Okay. So in physics also we can use this. For example, complicated parts, complicated products, and all that. Yes. Next is the art form. For example, small, small artistic, small, small things which we can 3D print. There are some complex, for example, pulley systems, how pulley systems work and all that. We can really 3D print a real-time pulley and show them how exactly it's been 3D printed. Okay. Now, so in our product which we provide, so you get an FDM 3D printer of 25-25 centimeter bed size, which can print PLA, ABS, PETG, and lot of these kind of things. And these products can be 3D printed in like in different sizes. We have 3D printed mechanical parts, we have 3D printed a lot of different parts. The printer quality is 0.1 mm accuracy, and it is an FDM 3D printer with around 150 degrees temperature of bed and around 300 degrees temperature of the nozzle. So you can print till nylon. You can print PLA, ABS, PETG, TPU, TPE, nylon, PEEK, and these all prints. It has auto bed leveling system. It has automatic filament sensor. Basically, we can 3D print what all I have showed you. For example, these parts have been 3D printed in our own, what do you say, in our own 3D printers. These parts, these, and these. So these parts, so 3D printers of whatever we provide, we can 3D print a lot of this stuff very easily and perfectly. Like you can see there are no intricacies, there are no problems while 3D printing. And you can see that these kind of parts also, the right now they are being 3D printed, and we provide these kind of printers too. So almost all kind of 3D printed parts we can provide you, and we can 3D print for you. Yes. Next, just a second. I will answer some of your questions. Is consumption of electricity more? No. Consumption of electricity is 100 watts to 360 watts, which is normal. A normal mixer grinder or a normal heater has around 1200 watts of energy is been released out of it. So this is not even like, it's like two or three fans, that's all. And PDF will be sent, I guess. And can we make 3D printing faster, or it's design based? Okay, so we can, so there is a compromise always. We can make 3D printing faster, but it will have less quality. If you want really more quality, you have to make it slower. If you want, for example, mechanical parts, we can print bigger parts in a less time, like really, really less time. For example, we can we have printed windmills and all that in a really less time. But when we want really high quality parts, for example, this kind of jewelry and all that, we really need to print it for hours. It's like 18 hours, 19 hours easily. Yes. Any other queries? But online, there are available at 10K to 15K. What is the difference? Okay. So online 3D printers, whichever are available, they're unassembled 3D printers. There are printers available from 10K to 30, like around 60K. The size of the printer is very small. It needs a lot of tuning, the software, the hardware. For example, like if we take Ender 3 or we take any other kind of example, it needs a lot of tuning to get it to the level that the quality is really high. Because the quality of 3D printer should be really good for you to get really good parts. Plus we provide, for example, you have any query, you have any problem with the 3D printer, any problem, you can call us anytime, 24/7. We provide service for that. We provide like each and every part which we provide, like we have totally known, we have the total understanding of it. And what that does is that, for example, there is a major, for example, power outage or power shortage, something which did the printer some kind of mishappening. Then you can just call us and we can solve the problem for you really quickly. And that's the major advantage that we provide service. These printers which you buy on online market, they won't provide you service. You won't, like, we have bought some of them. We have tested them. So there, for example, the printer life of 15 to 20K printer is around 200 hours or 300 hours. Means after 300 hours, you cannot expect really high quality of 3D print. And that's how the difference between the really good quality printers and mid-range printers and high-range printers occurs. Okay. Yeah, how much space it will take? So the printer which we provide you is 500 size. That is 50 centimeters square. So that is more than enough for a 3D printer to be established. It is not that much, like 500 is like your table size. It's in your 4 by 2 feet table, 2 feet it will take, 2 by 2 feet. And if you have a UPS or something like that, if you want, and filaments and all that to place them, you need just a shelf and all that. So it is very easy. Set up a lab or build. Yeah, so that's the reason. Printed material which we can recycle. Yes, we can recycle. Did I answer all of your questions? Or are there any questions remaining in anyone's mind, or else I have slipped them off? Please respond back. Any questions? Any questions? If light goes off, yes, it will start. It will continue from the. It has auto resume function. What we talk about, it will resume from where it has stopped. But still, I recommend you people have UPS, because what happens is it cools down. The part cools down, the bed cools down, the nozzle cools down, and it gets stuck to the part. So you yes, it has auto resume function, but always have a UPS, because for example, there will be prints of around 18-20 hours and it's like last 2 hours are remaining. So at that time you need auto resume function, and we have it. Yes. Anything else? Any other doubts? Yeah, so no doubts at all, right? I hope you people enjoyed the session, and I also thank everyone to cooperate and sit with us. Thank you so much.